Now, even scientists have a hard time counting chromosomes that are just disorganized like this. We know now that there are 46 chromosomes in here somewhere, but obviously trying to see which one is which can be difficult. So what we want to do is what scientists do, which is try to find them and line them up in order of biggest to smallest. And I'm actually going to give you a little taste of that here. And I'm actually going to try to organize them by literally cutting and pasting them one by one. Okay, so this was my very amateur job at trying to organize these chromosomes in order from biggest to smallest. You can see it. There are some imperfections here. I probably didn't get it right because this isn't my job. This isn't something I do on a regular basis. But let's take a look at how scientists actually would put them in a row. Okay, so here's what it looks like if a professional scientist who works with chromosomes and knows what they're doing here, if they cut and paste them and organize them, they'll get ordered in this way. So I want you to pay really close attention to all the chromosomes that you see here and see if there's any kind of pattern that stands out to you. What I want you to tell me is if you see any pattern that stands out in all of these chromosomes when they're ordered in this fashion from biggest to smallest. Try to think of an answer, one or two word response if possible, and put it in the text box here. Don't worry so much about getting this question right or wrong. Just try to look for any pattern that you see and then put it in the text box here.